ground scan. The ground scan system is a completely new system in new mega detection devices with new and improved technology. This system helps the user to scan the ground and create a 2D visualization on the device screen, or 3D visualization on any supported Android tablet via multi-visual analyzer app. This system can make searching and finding burials and underground cavities such as tunnels and basements easy for the user with greater speed and accuracy. Device installation. 1. Connect the VST probe. 2. Use the power socket on the bottom of the main unit to connect the battery. Note: ensure that the antenna's unit is locked and closed so that the unit is stable during use. System selection. To start using the ground scan system, select it from the main menu. After selecting the ground scan system from the main menu, a new screen will appear to select the device on which the results will be displayed. There are two options: device and tablet. Selecting device in this list means that the user can see results directly on the device screen. Selecting tablet in this list means that the user can see the results on the tablet screen that came with the device that includes multi-visual analyzer application to display the results visually. Set up to display results on device screen. Scan mode. On this screen, the user can choose the scan mode, and there are two options. 1. Manual mode. The user performs the scanning process manually. Is, he records measurements manually at each scan point. 2. Automatic mode. In this case, the device will automatically scan the points without user intervention, as it scans the points automatically with an interval between each point. User only has to press on start button at start of next scan line. To choose the appropriate scan mode, use the left-right arrow buttons, then press the OK button. Scan path. On this screen, the user can specify the direction of the scanning path, which includes two options. 1. One direction. The ground scan is performed for each line with the same direction, i.e., the direction of the scan is according to parallel lines and a distance between them. 2. Zigzag. In this case, the start of the next scan line is at the end of the previous scan line, while leaving an offset distance, meaning that every two successive lines are scanned in an opposite direction. Select your preferred scan path mode using the left-right arrow buttons, then press the OK button. Scan area size. The user can choose the dimensions of a scanning area using this screen, which are width, lines. It's the number of scan lines, and can be set using the up-down arrows. Then press the OK button. Height, steps. This number expresses the number of scanning steps, or points, for each line, and it can be changed by using the up-down arrows and then pressing the OK button. To understand the difference between lines and steps, look at the following figure. When the user stands straight in the search area, every step he takes forward is called a scan point, or step. And every time the user moves to the left or right, it's called scan line, meaning he moves to a new scan line. Start point. Here, the user can specify the starting point of the scan within the area, and there are two options. Left. The start of the scan is in the lower left corner of the scanning area. Right. The start of the scan process is from the lower right corner of the scanning area. The location of a starting point can be selected using the left-right arrow buttons, then pressing the OK button. Scan. After completing all the previous settings, the user will see a screen showing the settings chosen through the previous steps. You can press the button at the bottom of the screen. Press OK to scan, to actually start the scanning process. How to use. After the setup is complete, make sure the device is fully and correctly assembled. Hold the device in the following manner, and make sure that you're holding the device fixed to your body without moving. Then stand on the zero or starting point in the scanning area and press the start button, located under the handle of the device. Keep the device height steady while scanning, at approximately a constant distance from the ground. Make sure to record the scan point at each point by pressing the start button in manual mode before moving to the next point. The minimum area of a rectangular scan area must be observed, as it must be at least 3 by 3 meters in size, and it's preferable that the dimensions of the scan area be 3 by 3, 6 by 6, or 9 by 9, with a 30 centimeter distance between each scan point. If there is an uneven area of land, first clean the area and arrange it as flat as possible before performing the actual scan. Continue scanning step by step according to the scanning paths you selected, one direction or zigzag. After each line of the scanning process is completed, you'll see an alert on the screen, which means you have to start a new scan line. Change your position to the beginning of the next line and then press the start button located under the handle of the device. On the screen appears a window that includes a grid of cells according to the number of lines and steps previously set. In the right pane, you can see information about the current step, current scan line, and numeric value of the probe during the scanning process. When the scanning process is completed, you'll see an alert on the screen stating that the scanning process is complete. Press OK to exit. During the scanning process, you'll see the color change of each cell of the grid, according to the current scan point, according to different colors. The user can know whether there is a target under the scanned ground or not by the color of each cell. Scan files. You can choose the Scan Files option from the main menu. Then press the OK button and a new screen appears. This screen includes a list of all the saved files that you can open and review. Every time the user selects a file, a pop-up window appears with three options: Open, Delete, Cancel. To choose, press the OK button. Grid lines. This option shows or hides the grid lines that represent the scanning area, where each cell represents one scanning step, scan point. Choose a cell from the grid. Use this option to select a specific cell from the scanning area grid within the scanning results screen. After clicking on the search icon, use the arrow buttons on the button board to select a specific cell. To return to the scanning tools, press the back button. Color filter. Use this option to hide or show the green color, representing normal ground. This is useful for showing areas of the scan that include metal targets or voids. Color ratios. The three color bars, red, green, blue, represent the percentages of each target type within the specified cell from the scan area. Average. This field represents an average value of all values in the detected points. Depth. When the selection is made on the cell, the depth value will appear in the lower information bar, and the user can see the depth in each cell with this option.